So shout out to the squad out there. If you're new, hit the like button. If you're new, hit the subscribe button. Welcome to the Bartertown conglomerate, surviving the digital age. Make sure that you guys hit that bell notification, subscribe to the channel, join our Telegram, which is home base, join our Twitter, and of course, join the squad. The Bartertown conglomerate is a hub for surviving the digital age in this, you know, unforgiving DeFi wasteland. You know, you have pits and snares out there, traps. And, you know, we gather together here at the Bartertown conglomerate to exchange information, goods, and resources so that way we can go out there and dominate cryptocurrency. Shout out to the squad. So, yeah, you definitely want to join Bartertown conglomerate chat. And I've been alerting, you know, our members at Bartertown that there's an opportunity amongst us, and that opportunity is in the Caspa ecosystem. Now, you know, I've never done a video on Caspa, but, you know, this is a token that I've accumulated, you know, like at a few cents, and it has seen some parabolic growth. As you can see, this is the chart of Caspa, probably one of the best performers of this cycle. You know, when you compare it to some other top 300, top 200 tokens. And also, within this past, I'm going to say, within this past, like, week or so, CAS has been outperforming, you know, all the top biggest 100 cryptocurrencies out there on a down market, right? After, you know, a political debate. And, you know, the market has a lot of uncertainty, but the market seems to be certain that Caspa is something that is piquing high interest amongst, you know, the cryptocurrency overall community. And, you know, Caspa is today in about an hour and 15 minutes, you know, we're going to be able to mint and utilize KRC20. And KRC20 is similar, if you guys understand what's going on with Bitcoin, runes and BRC20s. It's the same type of protocol built on Caspa. Real quick, just to get into the what is Caspa? What is Caspa? Caspa is a decentralized POW, proof of work blockchain network that employs a BlockDAG ledger structure aiming for rapid and scalable and secure transactions with no central governance, guys. So in a nutshell, this is what is to be advertised as an upgraded version of Bitcoin, a version of Bitcoin that has smart contract capabilities. And that's what we're going to be seeing with the launch of KRC20s, where there's going to be mints on top of the Caspa tokens, inscriptions on top of Caspa. And people are going to be able to mint out different tokens. And also we're going to see marketplaces. Also, we're going to see DEXs. And the Caspa ecosystem is going to be able to grow and evolve from the egg that it was. So scalability. Caspa uses BlockDAG structure, processing multiple blocks in parallel for increased throughput, ensuring rapid and scalable transaction sequencing. So high security, utilizing a K-heavy hash algorithm and proof of work. Caspa ensures robust security, mitigating risk like 51% attacks and minor extractable value threats. So they've seen some of the different issues that Bitcoin could potentially have, and its competitors also. And, you know, they created Caspa to be this super, super futuristic cypherpunk type of cryptocurrency. Decentralization, emphasizing community involvement. Caspa is an open source and fair launch with no pre-mining, no or central governance, ensuring decentralized control and development. And today we are seeing the token standard, the KRC20, an upcoming token standard for the Caspa blockchain, enabling the creation, transfer, and management of digital tokens similar to ERC20. So guys, today's day one. You know what I'm saying? Today is an opportunity, even though maybe you missed, you know, the initial rally up. but today's day one of KRC20s. And I wanted to position the squad to be able to get a foothold on, you know, these particular opportunities, right? So now KRC20s and, you know, a lot of what's going to come out initially is going to be very speculative, right? You know, similar to, you know, your favorite meme coins at launch. But of course, guys, I would imagine, you know, nothing is financial advice, but I would imagine that there's going to be a blue chip or several blue chips that will emerge from this initial core group of KRC20s. And, you know, we want to be, you know, members of those communities and participants and have our share in this history that's going on within the Casper ecosystem. So, guys, what I'm going to try to attempt to do is just show you all the alpha that I have accumulated. And, of course, I will be giving more further updates at Bartertown Conglomerate. You guys can go join the Bartertown Conglomerate announcement and news channel. And, you know, you go hashtag or you put the money sign or you search hashtag Casper. And I'll be adding to this list as I go along and adding different posts. We keep things very informative at Bartertown. We're in all sorts of different areas in DeFi, dominating cryptocurrency. That's what we do. So, all right. So we got this out the way. You guys have a basic understanding of what Casper is, a proof of work token that has smart contract upgrade ability. And I want to show you guys how to get started first. Now, first and foremost, guys, you're going to need a wallet. And this particular wallet is called Casware.xyz. And all of these links are going to be in the description. Okay. Casware.xyz. And you want to download your Casware. You can, you know, download Casware to your, you know, Google Chrome, or I suggest you use Brave browser. That's my favorite one. And you can download that. And once you download that, guys, for you noobs out there, for you people who are new to crypto, make sure that you write down your seed phrase and do not write in neat print. Don't write it sloppy. Make sure the words are clear. So that way when your computer breaks, unfortunately, or there's a water accident or something in your house, you'll be able to recover your address and you won't say, oh man, is that an S or is that an E, right? So you want to make sure that you're utilizing Casware. And after you're done installing your Casware, it's going to look something like this, right? And you want to send tokens to your address. So one of the easiest ways to be able to get Casper token without having to go on a centralized exchange, which I recommend you try to avoid as much as possible, is by going to something like a changenow.io. Of course, the link is in the description. And you can go from any crypto asset that you want into Casper, right? So you want to click Casper on the bottom. On the top, you want to pick whatever asset that you're going to use. And of course, if you're brand new to crypto, you can go to a centralized exchange. I also have non-KYC options. You guys can check some other videos that I have on the channel, you know, on how to get crypto, you know, peer-to-peer and different things like that, which is the preferred way that I recommend you guys start your cryptocurrency journey. And of course, guys, if you need any help, you can come to Bartertown. Bartertown is a hub, a safe haven, a place where you can come and get the information that you need. Of course, make sure that you're in the right chats. Make sure you're using the right links. Don't get caught out there with copy clones out there, fake Bartertown profiles that might lure you into some pit. You know, make sure you're in the right place. So you can go from BTC, get your cash token, and make sure that your receiving address is your address, you know, that you have here on your Casware, and it's going to send right to your Casper wallet, and you're going to have your tokens there. And of course, it's connecting to network right now because KRC20 network is not live at the moment. It's going to be live in about an hour from the time that I'm doing this video. But of course, the activity is going to be recorded you know, you sending whatever tokens to this particular wallet, and you know, you're gonna have all your data here. So now, of course, you receive, you send, boom, this is the address that you're using to be able to receive your tokens. So now, a couple of things. So all right, Ray, I have my my cash in my wallet, I'm ready to go. I know the minting starts in about an hour. How do I mint, Ray? So I'm gonna show you guys quickly how to mint. So Casper Cats, which is one of the, you know, one of our picks for today. They definitely put some good information out there for us. So how to mint KCATS KRC20 tomorrow using Casper Wallet. Navigate to the bottom and select the sensor icon. Click the mint icon at the top. So what we're gonna do is this is how it's gonna be. Right now it's on like a test net. We're gonna be on KRC20. We're gonna click the bottom middle button with the four boxes, and then it's gonna say KRC20 mint and deploy. And then this is the ticker of whatever we wanna mint. So we're gonna type in the ticker. I'm gonna show you tickers later. And then you wanna set your priority, you know, based on how much Casper you wanna use to force a transaction to go through. So think about it like this, guys. Imagine we're all bidding, and the highest bidder of that block is going to be able to get their mint through. So, you know, some people are gonna bid higher than others, and some transactions are gonna go through faster than others. So that's how it's gonna work, right? Depending on what, you know, what KRC20, right, that you wanna mint. There's gonna be higher demand for some, there's gonna be less demand for others. So we're gonna be able to have various, priority that we can use for each of them. So like in the field on the top, type in KCATS, which is their mint, and select how much you want to mint using the sliding scale or by manually typing in the box on the right. Confirm mint and sign the transaction. Minting will begin, and the status of each mint is displayed. Once completed, a minted message will appear. Note, the browser needs to remain open when the minting is processing or the transaction will fail. That's one thing that I noticed real quick, sidebar. When you're using the Casper wallet and you're typing in your password initially, because you know you have to set your own password for your wallet, when you press enter, it, for me at least, it closes the box that pops up. So like I type in my password, and then normally I would press enter and it'll confirm the password that I have and open up my Casper. What I notice is that you have to manually click, you know, confirm for your password, and then it'll override and go through. So just, you know, we're trying to be quick to the draw today, you know what I'm saying? So let's make sure, just any little detail, I just want to make sure that I mention it. So look, this is the different priority depending on what you want to do with your mint. You could deploy your own KRC20, which is very cool, right in the wallet. And then this is testnet, so this is how it's gonna look. It's gonna look like one of these, similar to BRC20, if you guys are familiar. And then you can go into it and you're gonna be able to see, you know, in real time, you know, how it looks. Okay, cash balance, boom, boom, boom. And that's gonna load up and go through. So pretty interesting. And then once it's minted, you have the confirmation, and then your cats and the amount that you're minting is gonna pop up right there. So that's pretty awesome. Let me see something. Okay, this is the amount that you're gonna be able to mint, priority transaction fee, and then you're gonna be able to set the amount that you want to force, you know, the transaction to go through. This is the amount that you wanna mint. All right, cool. So real simple, man, it's real simple. So I have some interesting, well, this is one interesting tool that I'm gonna be able to show. This is called casplex.org. And what this is gonna allow you to do, at least for now, has some information here. But what's really cool is that you're gonna be able to, this is testnet right now, but it's gonna, mainnet should open up as soon as this thing, in 1 hour from now. So you're gonna click on KRC20, and then what we're going to be able to see on mainnet is all the available KRC20 tokens that are going to be able to be minted. Don't get testnet and mainnet confused. Keep that in mind, all right? And then you're going to be able to search, you know, for whatever it is that you need. In progress, obviously it means in progress. Completed means completed. So the amount of holders, transactions, and we're going to be able to see in real time, you know, what which one is getting demand and which one is not getting demand. Look, MAGA's coming out here. I'm sure, you know, we Casper culture is going to determine what's popular and what's not. This is all a speculative play at first. But remember, Casper, this is the initial stages of Casper. This is how it's going to evolve. But over time, we're going to see DEXs. Over time, we're going to see marketplaces. Over time, we're going to see different applications and usage for the Casper ecosystem as the builders build. But initially, it's all speculative. So, you know, speculative plays usually bring the highest returns. From what I'm seeing in this PvP market that we're in, this player versus player market, speculative plays are paying the most. So sometimes we have to go knee deep into, you know, that muddy, those muddy waters, you know what I'm saying? And figure out, you know, where that treasure is. Sometimes the buried treasure is not in the dirt, you know what I'm saying? So we got to go a little deeper sometimes to see what we're going to do. All right. So now we covered, you know, how to do things, wallet. And I gave you guys a nice tool, right? Nobody's talking about this tool, baby. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, we got that. Links are going to be in the description and at Bartertown. So, okay. Now, I have a few plays that I like. This is going to be one of them. KCATS is on the highest ones on my list, right? KCATS is going to be definitely one of the highest on my list. And I think it serves its purpose well. And I believe the developer of KCATS is an actual developer. So I'm imagining him to be able to scale what he wants to do here and build some, you know, unique protocol. So between KCATS and also Casper the Ghost, Casper, I think, has the highest amount of followers out of all the KRC20 tokens. So I believe that this is going to be something that a lot of people are going to move towards. They have a little game on their site, too, if you want to play their game. Something really simple, but look, they have voting and, you know, they're doing something over here. So we'll see. Those are two that I'm definitely looking to mint. Also, I've accumulated a nice, you know, we sent our scouts out there, and our scouts have returned with a nice little list here. I'm hearing good things about Gold. I'm hearing good things about Cass Paul. So those are two other ones that, you know, I hear some noise about. I was interested in Kit and Keck, but, you know, nah, that thing doesn't have enough followers on it. So from this list will not be in the description. If you want this list, you have to come get it at Bartertown. But of course, you could just read it and copy whatever you want to do. That's it, guys. I don't want to make this video too long-winded. I'll do some more future Casper videos in the future if you guys want to see it. And if there's some developments out there that are coming out. So, of course, guys, shout out to the squad out there. And, you know, salute to the squad. Call me some metamorphs, call me a couple. Cutting these pivots, tending these truffles. Watching this butter top, in the conglomerate. Standing curl butter, big boy needs a puzzle. Call me some metamorphs, call me a couple. Cutting these pivots, tending these truffles. Watching this butter top, in the conglomerate. Standing curl butter, big boy needs a puzzle. MLP for the piggy bank. Dropping the sauce, got 'em on my back. Bartertown up, check the